This video is sponsored by the brand new JV Jiu-Jitsu online store at jvjiu-jitsu.bigcartel.com. What's going on, everybody? This is Javi Vasquez. In chapter 16, we discuss armlock final control bottom. This is one of the most frustrating and difficult positions to escape, especially if the top opponent understands how to maintain control. One of the main difficulties is that the top opponent is one step away from finishing you with a submission. There are three primary ways that I use to escape final control bottom. The first is the knee getup escape, where you come up to your knees and put downward pressure on your opponent until you can eventually pull your arm out, ending up in Chapter 7, guard top. The second is the northern escape, where you take your opponent's leg off your head and either end up in Chapter 7, guard top, or Chapter 8, guard bottom. And finally, the southern escape, which I call the elbow escape. In this video, I will discuss the southern escape route utilizing the elbow escape. I will discuss how to achieve the elbow escape using level 1 or low resistance when the opponent does not have their feet crossed. If you have any questions on this technique or would like to see me break down any other technique, please leave a comment in the comment section below. Click like and subscribe to my channel for more strike-based jiu-jitsu content, and as always, thank you for watching.
So chapter 16, which is final control defense. So when you're under here, I think one of the more common game plans is to maybe lean the guy back, bridge, turn your hips, and eventually pull the arm out. But when the opponent on top understands how to kickstart the Harley and understands how to stop you from sitting up. Sometimes they're bigger, they're very strong. Sometimes coming up is very hard. It's very hard for me in particular because I've got a bad wheel, so it's hard for me to bridge in. So I've come up with a different way to attack the problem. Now, right now, we're just going to deal with the feet being uncrossed because we need to know what direction we're going first. And then we'll figure out how to deal with the cross feet, which we can deal with. So the first thing that happens is my hands are going to be locked. And the other thing too is a lot of times you land here and the feet aren't crossed. So this works really well. So I'm going to start with my hands locked. I will generally not bury like this. If I grab my biceps and bury the arm because you can't use the elbow the way I need. If I can get here, I'll use a different escape route. But if I only have my hands locked or S-grip, this is the escape route that I'm choosing here. What I need to do is I need to place his foot between my legs. So the easiest way to do this is to use my elbow to scoop under his heel. As I start to push his leg south, my knees come north, and I'm going to use my outside leg to hook his heel. Now, when I hook his heel, he can pull his foot out, though, over. But what I'm going to do is just like a pair of scissors, this leg goes down, this leg goes up. I'm going to create a little bit of tension here to control the leg. So now if he tries to pull his leg out, it's stuck. So to give me even more control, I'm going to do the little scissor move here. I'm going to cross my feet, making sure that the leg that's on the heel is on the bottom. That will make a difference. If you do this, it feels different than this. Now, from here, I'm going to extend my legs away, and I'm going to roll to my right hip. So as I roll to the hip, I bite above his knee. This is an important movement here, because what I'm doing is a lot of guys will get to here and try to head, no, extension, and then bite. So now I've bitten above the knee. Now, from here, it changes the angle. So right now, my arm is directly perpendicular to his body. When I bite high here, my hand goes north, which allows my elbow to go south. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to open his knees as far as possible so that my elbow can come around and then go to the ground. That's the idea. So immediately I will scoop the heel, I will cross and extend. Extension will create his legs opening. And the other thing I'll do is I'll kind of, you see how I'm kind of pushing his arm north? One, two, I pull him here, which will get me a high bite on top of his leg. Once my elbow comes out, boom, now I'm out, I'm good. I'm good to go here, I'm gonna hug his leg. Now I need to come up to my elbow and knees, but if I start to come up to my knees directly, it's gonna take the pressure off of his leg. So what I'm gonna do to maintain pressure, I'm gonna bridge this way here, and then rotate my knees underneath me. When I rotate my knees underneath me, my legs stay somewhat straight so that I can pull my hand out. So if he tries to push me back, my hand's on the ground, and now I roll over him. So by rolling over him, his legs are apart. Even if he takes his leg off my head, I catch it. I don't want his feet to cross. So as he tries to cross his feet, I keep his feet across, and I can step my leg out. So a lot of times you'll land here, and his feet are uncrossed. I directly attack the heel. Now you're thinking to yourself, well, sometimes what happens is he lays on his side and kickstarts the heart of the heel. Yeah, right, you can still scoop and do the exact same thing. So even though kickstarting the Harley does work incredibly well, you can't kickstart the Harley and keep your feet crossed. So anytime his feet become uncrossed, I'm scooping. As I scoop, look, I turn on my side. I don't have to stay flat on my back. I turn on my side, I catch the heel, and I cross my feet. Make sure that the hooking leg is on the bottom. I'm controlling his leg here with my inner thigh as I push down here with the back of my knee on his heel. Extension, turn, and bite. When I bite, my hand goes north, elbow goes south. If you can get to his head, get to his head. Otherwise, you're gonna catch a hold of his hip and then bridge up to your shoulder and roll. Pushing back, clear. Yep, and now I adjust my hip by shrimping north. So my hip is under his arm. And now, make sense? So the extension, the scissor control is important. You want extension and you want that momentum. So you want to extend and rotate all at once. So if I do it by myself, I scoop here, I extend, then I do this. So I'm extending him away, widening his legs. I roll to my other hip, and then I pull as I bring him into biting above his knee with my. Can you do the rollout just by controlling at the angle? Yes, but I feel that if you can bite above the knee, it gives you a little bit better control. Question? Go.
Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching my video. Please click like and subscribe to my channel for more great strike-based jiu-jitsu content. If you have any questions about the techniques that I'm demonstrating, please leave a comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much.